हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ रवि मालाका। आई एम असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट इन CITM कॉलेज जयपुर। टुडे वी विल स्टडी WDM एंड DWDM सिस्टम्स इन डिटेल्स। आउटलाइंस ऑफ दिस लेक्चर्स आर बेसिक्स ऑफ WDM एंड DWDM सिस्टम्स, देन देयर आर्किटेक्चर्स। वी विल स्टडी वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल लेटर्स, देन वी विल ऑल्सो स्टडी कंपोनेंट यूज इन WDM एंड DWDM सिस्टम। Then in last we will study advantage and disadvantage of these systems. First we are studying WDM systems. WDM system stands for wavelength division multiplexing. It increases the capacity of single standard fibers. Different wavelength signals of laser light are transmitted from the transmitter. These sources use narrow portion of available bandwidth. That's why we use laser light here. Multiplexer transmit all signals into single fibers. At receiver end, the multiplexer separate different wavelength signals and send it to different receivers. WDM architectures. WDM are generally of two types, unidirectional and bidirectional. In unidirectional, at one side we can use transmitter and at other side we can use receivers. So here in these figures we can see कि ट्रांसमीटर ट्रांसमिट डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ सिग्नल्स लाइक लैम्बडा 1, लैम्बडा 2, लैम्बडा 3 एंड लैम्बडा 4। देन मल्टीप्लेक्सर कंबाइन दिस सिग्नल्स एंड सेंड इट टू ऑप्टिकल फाइबर्स। डी मल्टीप्लेक्सर सेपरेट दिस सिग्नल्स एंड सेंड इट टू डिफरेंट रिसीवर्स। इन बाई डायरेक्शनल, एट वन साइड बोथ ट्रांसमिशन एंड रिसीविंग ऑफ सिग्नल्स आर पॉसिबल्स। हेयर वी कैन सी we are using both multiplexer and demultiplexers at one side. So lambda 1 and lambda 2 here are transmitting wavelength. Then multiplexer combine this wavelength and send it to optical fibers. Then demultiplexer separate these wavelengths and transmit it to receivers. Here we can also see lambda 3 and lambda 4 are transmitting signals. Then these signals transmit multiplexer combine these signals and transmit it to optical fibers. Then demultiplexer separate these signals and send it to receivers. So it means bidirectional transmission of signals are possible. Components of WDM systems. Optical line terminals. These are used to connect multiple transporter to optical fibers. Optical multiplexer and demultiplexer. Multiplexer combine the different wavelength signals at input terminals and demultiplexer separate different wavelength signals at output terminals. Optical cross connect. It provides switching between terminals using routing algorithms. Advantage and disadvantage of WDM systems. In advantage is wavelength reuse is possible. Wavelength conversion also possible. It provides higher bandwidths. Full duplex transmission is possible. In disadvantage, signal cannot be very close. Difficulty in cascaded topology. Cost of system increase with addition of optical component. Now we are studying DWDM systems. It stands for dense wavelength division multiplexing. Dense means signals are very close to each other. That's why transmission is possible at higher bandwidths. It is used to increase bandwidths over existing fiber networks. DWDM works by combining and transmitting multiple signals simultaneously at different wavelengths on same fibers. Technically, ITUT recombination G692 specifies a channel with spacing of 100 GHz. EDFA solves attenuation and dispersion problem of WDM systems. Because here we use EDFA amplifier for boosting the strength of the signals and their transmission bandwidths. EDFA works at the window of 1.55 micrometer wavelength. DWDM architectures. Same as WDM systems, these are possible at unidirectional and bidirectional both sides. Here, these figures are of bidirectional DWDM architectures. In bidirectional DWDM architecture, Both transmission and receiving of the signals are possible at both sides. So, process is same as WTM systems. Like from the transporter, different wavelength signals are transmitted. Then multiplexer combine these signals and send it to optical fibers. Here we use OADM. OADM is stand for optical add drop multiplexer. It means it add or drop the wavelength as per requirement. Then we use EDAP amplifier for boosting of the signals before sending it to demultiplexers. Then demultiplexer separate the different wavelength signals and send it to receivers. Same is applicable for WDM systems, but here we use EDFA and OADM. This is extra than WDM systems. Working principles of DWDM systems. First, transporters accept input in the form of a standard single mode or multiport laser pulse. The wavelength of the transport input signals is mapped to a DWDM systems. Then DWDM wavelength from the transmitter are multiplexed with signals from the direct interface to form a composite optical signals which is launched into fibers. A forced amplifier, booster amplifier boosts the strength of the optical signal as it leaves the multiplexers. A OADM is used at a remote location to drop and add with streams of a specific wavelength. A PD amplifier boosts the signals before it enters the demultiplexers. The incoming signal is demultiplexed into individual DWDM wavelength. Then, in last, individual DWDM wavelength are either mapped to the required output type through the transporter or they are passed directly to client-side equipment. Advantage and disadvantage of DWDM systems. Advantage: it increased fiber capacity. Easier network expansion is possible as we are adding here OADM and EDFA amplifier. Maximum distance transmission is possible. Usage of repeaters decrease. Every wavelength is independent on others. In disadvantage, complex technology requires, like more power is required, high accuracy lasers is required. It introduces another element, frequency domain element, to network design and management. So we have studied